All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Studios and welcoming in Nav Dhaliwal, the President and CEO of Bonterra Resources. Nav, how are you? Good to see you.
Hey, fantastic. Thanks for having me, Steve.
Well, we've got lots of exciting news to talk about, but before we do that, why don't you give everyone just a quick synopsis of Bonterra. And you became the CEO in 2012, and you've made a lot of changes since then.
Yeah, you know, 2012 is when I took over the company. Bonterra is currently listed on the TSXV under the ticker symbol BTR. So in 2012, I took over the company. It took me about a year and a half to kind of clean it up. Looking throughout the industry, I was, you know, I was mandated to get surrounded by guys that have taken projects such as the Gladiator Project in drilling holes and, you know, to the next level. So shortly after, I lined myself up with now the VP of Exploration, who is Dale Ginn. Mm-hmm. And since 2014, we've come a long way on this deposit, on the Gladiator deposit. You know, in 2017, we raised over $65 million with strategic investors, of the likes of Eric Sprott, Kirkland Lake Gold, Joe Foster from VanEck, Century Select, M&G out of the UK, Rougher Gold. So we've done one hell of a job of getting out there and not only changing over the roster, but expanding what we've started off with. So in 2012, I put a 43-101 out that was 200 meters by strike by 200 meters at depth, giving us about 250,000 ounces at 9 grams. Since then, and my hat's off to the team and their dedication to the project, we've stretched this deposit out over 1.3 kilometers.
Wow.
At strike by over a kilometer at depth, discovering 5 new zones. And actually, this is the exciting part, is we've just discovered a 6th zone.
Wow.
And that came about because just recently, about 4 months ago, we did a deal with our neighboring company called Bullfield, and we acquired that. We're working on a JV with that company.
Okay.
So what that does for the folks out there that are listening, it allowed us to push the boundaries of our property boundaries.
Right.
So it allowed us to push our rigs back, and lo and behold, about a quarter mile up, we discovered a new zone where we have 7 meters of 27 grams per ton, about 100 meters down. And, and that's just the north zone. So again, this deposit keeps growing, keeps talking to us. Very excited about it.
And that's a significant point, is the fact that you already had those zones that you talked about earlier that were doing really well. Now with the added one as well, where are you as far as the next step on that property?
The next step on that property, and that's a great question, is, you know, we've showcased that we've been able to get out there and kind of showcase how this, you know, this typical Abitibi greenstone quartz vein hosted gold deposit, how we've been able to understand how it's moving and growing it. We've proven the continuity through it all. So the next step is we're going to be issuing or publishing in early October a new updated 43-101.
Okay. And that'll give everyone an idea of what the next step is.
Exactly. Yeah. Exactly.
You also here to announce an acquisition, $77 million to purchase a company. And this is very significant because of not necessarily who that company is, but more of what they have and where they are. So tell us the company and why you decided to go after them.
Absolutely. And that was something that we just accomplished here yesterday. We took over Metnor. We purchased them for about $77 million, an all-share transaction.
Yeah.
And, you know, looking at Bonterra, you know, with management, we were looking at what's our next leg up. Yeah, we've got a good handle on the Gladiator deposit. We've got a lot of exploration upside. But, you know, seeing that the Urban Barry camp is going to probably be the next high-grade gold camp in Quebec, what's the next leg up for our shareholders?
Sure.
Looking at Metnor, they had checked all the right boxes for us. They have the Barry deposit that's next door to the Gladiator. It's the only permitted deposit in the area. Mm-hmm. You know, so they've got... they've got a good, strong understanding. They've driven a decline down to the shears. You know, that was just recently taken over and cleaned up by Greg Gibson, the chairman there. He's done one hell of a job taking it to a certain point.
Okay.
And then further from that, what really got us excited was we acquired the only mill that's within 110 kilometers of this area. So that currently is at 1,200 tons per day, but it's been permitted for 2,400 tons.
Oh, wow.
So we should be receiving those permits in early 2019 to build that out. And currently right now, it's, you know, it's a 30,000 ounce producer. But what they did discover at Bachelor Mill is a new zone. It's called the Morroy Zone. Okay. And we're seeing that kind of flushing itself out. So we looked at the whole package together and said, you know, this is gonna take a lot of work. So what we're looking at is developing it. We're going to shut down production, and we're going to concentrate on expanding the Gladiator deposit, more exploration side of the work
right.
on the Morroy underground to the Barry to the Gladiator.
Well, while some people were taking the summer off, you were obviously extremely busy, because if that's not enough for you, we actually have even more news, and that's to do with Larder Lake. So tell us what's going on there, another big one.
Well, exactly. So again, you know, looking at the deposit and growing this and showing our shareholders that we want to continue creating value. We've had a project called the Larder Lake Project sitting in the company that hasn't really been adding value. It's had 1 million ounces. It's got a 43-101 with 1 million ounces on the Cadillac Larder Fault. Goldfields did a $40 million option on this property, shut down worldwide exploration in 2012, and left us with a significant amount of work. We've got a strong understanding on that deposit. So looking at how we were putting the urban barrier, we want to keep the focus in the urban barrier. So what we've done now is, through news release, you can see it, is for every 7 shares that you own currently of Bonterra, you're going to get one of a new co. So, and that new co is also going to be fully funded with $7 million. We feel very confident on that Bear Lake deposit, seeing right next door along that trend in Eco Eagle. Last December, bought out Yamana for right. $180 million. So again, it's getting very fruitful in the area. We look forward to getting out there and drilling right away and kind of, you know, making it the Bonterra 2.0.
Well, we're excited to hear when you get to that. Come back and tell us more about it when that happens. And it's great to talk to you. Thank you very much for the update.
Steve. I appreciate it.
Great stuff.
Thank you.
Nav Dhaliwal, very busy man as the president and CEO of Bonterra Resources.